Our distinguished guest for today, Dr. Radhakrishnan, Vice Chancellor Professor Jain, Director of the Hyderabad Campus Professor Rao, Dixians, parents, ladies and gentlemen. It is a great honor and privilege to have with us Dr. K. Radhakrishnan as our chief guest today. Dr. Radhakrishnan is an exceptional technocrat, a dynamic institution builder with a strategic vision, and an outstanding administrator. As chief of India's space program, Dr. Radhakrishnan has led ISRO's push into new directions, such as developing space applications for societal services and national imperatives, creating space assets for communication, remote sensing and navigation, enhancing indigenous capability and capacity for space transportation systems, and developing low-cost access to space. He played a key role in the development of GSLV Mark III, ISRO's next generation launch vehicle. He is also engaged in initiatives to develop India's aerospace industry and in encouraging academia to engage in frontline research activities in both space, science, and technology. Above all, he has contributed greatly to nurturing leadership skills in the younger generation. My heartiest congratulations to all of you graduating in the big class of 2014. I am sure that the memories and emotions of this convocation day will remain etched in your mind for long. My experience tells me that the feelings tend to be undoubtedly mixed. There is a sense of achievement, of having made it through a long and grueling academic steeplechase. There is the sense of heaviness tinged with apprehension as you say goodbye to friends and as you depart from the relatively cloistered cocoon that is academia. The transition that all of you are about to make is beautifully described by the title of the song by the legendary singer of the 1960s and 1970s, John Denver. Today is the first day of the rest of my life. On a day like this, I cannot but reinforce what I've said on many such occasions before. It is a brave new world out there, the one that you are stepping into. It is full of opportunities, full of challenges. It is also intensely competitive. And above all, if there is one unifying theme that straddles every facet of our world, it is the reality of unrelenting change, change that only accelerates over time. Just to get a sense of the changes that have been happening in our times, as recently as 10 years ago, as you would know, broadband was a relative novelty. Today, the rate of growth of broadband capacity and speed, as no one would know better than you, is accelerating, affecting the very way we live, the way we work, the way we stay connected. Think of mobile telephony, video calls, Skype, WhatsApp, social networks. Think retailing, Amazon, Flipkart, eBay, local banner. For sure, traditional bricks and mortar retailing will have to learn how to cope if they are to survive. What of the internet, which will virtually connect all devices and enable them to speak to each other, so to speak? What of other fields, medicine, biotechnology, nanotechnology, materials, energy, transportation, education, healthcare, and works? We can expect that there will be more sudden shifts and swings, sometimes completely out of blue. Today we are stepping into a world where change is a constant, where surprises, shocks, and volatility are the norm. Therefore, I think it appropriate to share with you some of my thoughts on how one can make sense of such a turbulent world and how you can respond, stay relevant, and harness the forces of change to your advantage. Let me first talk about making yourself change ready at a very personal level. Of course, technical skills are very necessary. These are your bedrock, and this is what you have acquired over the past 4 years. Keep advancing and sharpening your knowledge in these areas. Today, there are all too many options available to stay abreast of your core area of technical competence, including online education, meeting leading practitioners, and most of all, applying your knowledge to real-world problems. But these technical skills are by themselves not enough. Your knowledge has to be placed in a much broader context, and it is in this broader context that you need to position your core technical expertise. For instance, up until the 1970s, to give the example of automobiles, automobile engineers could afford to be specialists. Then came legal issues related to safety. Then there was a focus on making cars more environment friendly. And as energy costs rose, there were fuel efficiency factors to consider. In the most recent years, more and more electronics and computing are being packed into a car, from ignition control to steering and braking to GPS and entertainment systems. And now there are new materials, plastics, composites. The spectrum of technologies and disciplines, therefore, needed to make a car is now much, much broader. This evolution demands that a narrow specialist becomes conversant with contiguous technologies. Success requires widening the sweep of your thinking and your perspective. In addition to perspective and mindset, let me mention a few personal habits and attributes that I believe impart the element of discipline and equip you well to come out on top in a world of change. One, respect the virtues of rigor.
The sheer pace of today's life often tempts us to take shortcuts to become sloppy.
Rigor and the ability to synthesize information is the essence of what BITS has taught you. Hold on to that. Two, always take in the magnificence and wonders of the wider world. Education is not just about the degree. Read, read, and read. Be eclectic in your interests. Travel, wander through a museum, listen to great music. Be amazed by the wonders of nature, by the extraordinary human accomplishments over the ages. Three, fine-tune the art of listening. Listen to and pay close attention to people. That may sound simple and so obvious, but in our over-busy lives, with its many distractions, attention spans have shrunk markedly. Sharpen your ability to follow an argument, track logic and reasoning, detect illogic, listen to and feel the emotions that lie behind both logic and illogic. Empathize with the person who is feeling those emotions. Listen to the people who oppose you. Listen to the people who are your allies. Listen to their feelings, the arguments, the ideas, the interconnections. Four, live by the old age virtues of respect for others and humility. Arrogance blinds us to the way others see and relate to the world. Be honest enough to admit your mistakes, to work with people smarter and more competent than you are. And fifth, learn to work in teams. Today's organizations are all about teamwork. The complex world calls for a multidisciplinary approach. No one person knows it all. Most of the time, you will be working in teams and in projects. Working as a team member requires skills such as listening, selling your point of view, negotiating, and most importantly, making trade-offs. You just cannot function as a one-man band in such a new environment. No matter how broad the change or sweep, the sweep of change, there are some things in life that just don't change. And I'm talking here about personal values. Your values are the core principles that you live by, premised on your own individual beliefs and individual convictions. They serve as your life force, the North Star, the guiding beacon. Sticking to your values may often mean giving up a quick gain or accepting a temporary setback. But it's worth losing a battle if it's going to help you win the war. Resist the temptation to circumvent your values. Shortcuts inevitably prove to be self-defeating. Achievements built on the quicksands of opportunism never last. Achievements built on values last for a lifetime. Let me leave you with one last piece of advice, if you will. Be yourself, as Steve Jobs said, and I quote, "Your time is limited, so don't waste it living someone else's life," unquote. Discover your inner voice, your passion, and follow it wherever it leads to. Don't get distracted by the naysayers who say that you run the risk of straying off the beaten path. A startling number of young and great achievers and heroes were early on, as you know, considered as misfits, crazy, or even eccentric. Today, above all, the message I want to leave is dream big and dream bold. Believe in the power of dreams. Today, what we achieve is limited only by the power of our imagination. Too many young people, I find, don't chase their dreams for fear of leaving their comfort zones. Tie your dream to a solid purpose. Don't make position, money, power, fame your only goals. Dream about making a tangible difference to society. It is that sense of a larger purpose that will drive you and make you reach out for your dreams.